Hey, you're watching Cal Free Kicks and this is the Nike React Phantom Run Flyknit 2. As always, I'll be looking into five main things when I review this pair of sneakers, and at the end of the video, I'll give them an overall rating out of 5 stars. And if you like what you see, don't forget to give the video a big thumbs up while you're watching. Also, drop any comments below. And if you're new and you like what you see again, please do take 2 seconds just to subscribe to the channel below by clicking the subscribe button. And also, if you click the little bell that appears next to it, you'll get a notification every time a fresh video drops on the channel. Moving swiftly on, let's start by talking about how this sneaker looks. But before I do, let's get a quick look at these on feet. I think these sneakers look great on feet. I think Nike have done a really nice job with this Nike React Phantom Run 2 Flyknit silhouette. At the moment, it comes in 2 different colorways, but I'm sure Nike will release many more in future. What you're getting looks-wise with this sneaker is a nice flow from toe to tongue. I think it's got a really nice drop away on this sneaker, and also, massive fan of the Nike React midsole, and you get a huge chunk of it on this shoe. You get the normal Nike React cutaways along the side of the midsole on both sides. As you flip it over, you're getting just some pretty basic black tread on the toe area, and it's heavier tread here than on the rear of the sneaker. Now, on the rear of the sneaker, you're getting the normal React cutaways again. As you flip the sneaker back over, on the rear of the sneaker, you've got these plastic heel cups both sides with the Nike swoosh detailing on. They are very hard to the touch, quite substantial plastic heel cups on this sneaker. Then you've got the pull heel tag here with the Nike swoosh detailing and the Phantom branding. As we move the sneaker around to the top, the main feature of this sneaker is that it is completely laceless. So it is a full sock knit upper. To create some tension and some fit on the sneaker, Nike have woven this synthetic elastic material through the darker Flyknit part of the sneaker to create some grip and hold on the top of your foot to replace the traditional lacing system. And also, they've created quite a difference between the two fabrics used for the Flyknit on this shoe. The front toe box area in this lighter color is very, very scratchy to the touch and very synthetic to the feel, and also feels very lightweight. Whereas this gray area at the end of the toe box through to the heel is heavier set and a lot more of a sock-like textile feel to it. Next, I want to move on to their comfort, where I'm going to put this React Mid to the test normally on a curb, but today on my back doorstep. This chunky React midsole is one of my favorite midsoles out there at the moment on the market. I think the bounce and the responsiveness you get from this mid, from toe to heel, is brilliant. And when you're walking, you just feel like you're walking on air. There's so much responsiveness and bounce again in these that really I can't fault the comfort of this sneaker at all. What you're getting on the top of your foot is you're also getting a very nice feel from this sock knit upper. You're getting a very nice comfortable fit over the roof of your foot with these elasticated bands. One thing I would say in terms of comfort is that the back of the sneaker does feel a little bit loose, and I do find that with these sock knit fit shoes sometimes, that if the tension isn't quite right, then you are going to have a bit of slip at the heel. Now, if you're going to wear these for running, I would take that into consideration. Now, whilst I was walking around, I didn't really notice it too much, that if I broke out into any type of run or sprint, I could feel a little bit of slippage on my heel. Now that normally comes with shoes, again, that are sock fit. So just be wary of that. These are a completely true fit though. So it wasn't anything to do with the fact that they were too big or too small, because these are a perfect fit in the toe box area and the rest of the sneaker, but just at the back, again, a little bit loose on this elasticated rim for the sock knit part of the shoe. Next, I want to move on to their weight, where I'm going to pop them on the scales to show you how much they weigh. Tipping the scales at 293 grams. The upper of this sneaker, I guarantee, weighs absolutely nothing. All the weight is for this huge React midsole that you're getting. And when you're walking around, they do feel incredibly lightweight. And I love the fact that they come in at under 300 grams. Next, I want to move on to their breathability, where I really wanted to see if this split fly knit upper was going to be as breathable as I'd expect it to be. As you can see from the smoke test, the smoke did escape incredibly well from the toe box area of the sneaker. This front part of the sneaker, where Nike have used an incredibly well perforated, lightweight Flyknit material, but that only covers one third of the shoe. The breathability test showed that this heavier set textile sock-like fabric Nike have used for the remaining two thirds of the sneaker did not let the smoke escape well at all. Now that's a bit of a concern, considering that I would expect Flyknit sneakers to be incredibly breathable. That's gonna move me on to their price. Now these come in at £120. That's what you'd normally expect to pay for a pair of Nike React runners. But I think for these shoes, I wouldn't wanna pay that price, because I don't think they offer as much as the other Nike React runners out there. That's mainly because of the lacing system and the breathability. Now I wanna move on to their overall score. Now I'm gonna give these a low end 4 stars. I've got to give them 4 stars because I really like the way they look, and they are incredibly comfortable as a lifestyle shoe, and they are breathable, just not as breathable as I'd expect. And I think the price is a little bit steep. Also, I am concerned slightly that if you are going to use these as a runner, you're not going to get the expected fit from the back of the heel here, where this elasticated rim is, because I think at the end of the day, if you're wearing a pair of runners, for me, I always want laces. I just don't have full trust in the elasticated rim for the upper of this shoe. If you've liked what you've seen, again, don't forget to give the video a big thumbs up. Also, you can subscribe to the channel below or follow me on Instagram. Hopefully, I'll see you again soon for another sneaker review. Thanks for watching. Bye.